This is Bruce Baer, BAIR. I'm Ann Valancourt, PAC. I'm her partner and female menopause mentors. I have two sites, the PA Path and Get the Skinny, a blog and website for boomer men. And I want to talk to you about ticks and tick bites, from ticks of the Ixodes type, which are hard body ticks. They're also called three host ticks because they have a three phase life cycle, from larva to nymph to adult. And we're looking at Lone Star ticks, American Dog ticks in this line, and Blackleg or Deer ticks in this line. Each one of these little stripes is a half a millimeter. You can see that these dark areas are the actual tick sizes. They're quite tiny. They really, this size and this size could easily bite you for longer than 24 hours. You might not know it, particularly if they were in an area that was a little tougher, like they bit your backside or on your back. You might not know it, and actually I have patients all the time who come in who've pulled adult ticks off of them that were on overnight, you know, if they were unaware. The ticks are what I call stealth insects. They're able to bite and hide themselves, and I say that, you know, they have cloaking devices, you know, they can hide themselves, you don't know it. And these over here, Lyme disease. Right here, Starry, and maybe Lyme disease. Maybe Rocky Mountain spotted fever, we're not sure, but definitely Starry. I'll talk about that in a minute. Or no, excuse me, this is dog tick. This is Rocky Mountain spotted fever, and the Lone Star tick is Starry, and maybe one of the other two or both. We don't know about that yet, but definitely Starry, which is called Southern Tick Associated Rash Infection. So, let's take a look at deer ticks. Alright, here's the ones that cause Lyme disease. Larvae have to acquire it when they come out of the egg. They aren't infected. They acquire Lyme disease. These three stages up here can give it to you. We think they have to be on you for about 24 hours to transmit it because of the life cycle of the bacteria Borrelia burgdorferi. And here is their size compared to the edge of a dime. Of course, that's magnified, but it gives you an idea how small they are. Here's the Lone Star tick, called because of the dot on the back. This is a female. This is not her head. This is her mouth. Her head's actually here. This area is called the capitellum, and it's strictly made for gluing itself on and sucking blood. It glues these big mouth parts onto the skin. It has a hypostome here, which is like a hypodermic needle. It sticks in you and sucks your blood to get the blood to flow and to keep from being detected. It injects you with a bunch of different chemicals that keep the blood from clotting and keep you from knowing they're there. This tick gives you a Starry infection for sure, and this is what this female looks like when she's full. She can gain or ingest 600 times her weight in blood, and the only thing she's going to do from here is lay some eggs and die. Okay, this is the Lone Star tick territory, and you can see along the coast, all the way here across the Gulf. It's all the way up here. This is Oklahoma, edge of Nebraska. You know, in here you have Missouri and Arkansas, all the way up into Iowa, across southern Illinois and Indiana, all the way up here in Kentucky, kind of misses West Virginia, although you know they're there, you know, there's no such thing as them not being there, but kind of gives you an idea. Well, North Carolina is loaded with these ticks, and they're quite aggressive. When you get Starry, it looks a lot like Lyme disease. This is a Starry rash, courtesy of the CDC. You can see these various bite sites and the edges of the rash here caused by this. That's a Starry rash, Southern Tick Associated Rash Infection. Some people in our area call this Southern Lyme disease. Infectious disease people cringe when we do that. All right, Southern Tick Associated Rash Infection cases. This is up through 2004. Let's see, I think this is, this is like 5, 10, 15, 20, 25,000. Okay, so lots of infections, more than 20,000 diagnosed. Rocky Mountain spotted fever is caused by the dog tick. Here's a male, here's a female. They're born with this, so all three forms, you know, the adult, female, adult, male, the larvae, nymph, the adult can all give you Rocky Mountain spotted fever. I'm going to talk more about these symptoms in just a minute in number 2.